Kia ora. Good evening. The high-powered Serious Fraud Office is now investigating donations made to the New Zealand First Foundation.
Allegations around the Deputy Prime Minister's party came up last year, claiming the party had not disclosed donations when it should have. Here's political editor Jessica Much-Mackay.
In New Zealand, there are rules about declaring political donations in a bid to be transparent about who's funding our politicians. Now the Serious Fraud Office have been tasked with looking at whether New Zealand First broke the rules.
I'm going to allow them to do their job. I will make no judgment until that process is complete.
Winston Peters saying no thanks when we asked for an interview. In a statement saying the party will be reviewing its arrangement for party donations, adding the foundation sought legal advice and does not believe it has breached the Electoral Act. Mr Peters didn't offer to stand down.
His response to me when we had a brief discussion was that he welcomed the fact that this was going to be properly investigated.
The Electoral Commission flagged concerns, saying the donations were not properly transmitted to the party and not disclosed as required by the Electoral Act. But it can't investigate, so like a hot potato, it was flipped to police, who very quickly tossed it on, saying, "We have assessed the file and will be referring the matter to the Serious Fraud Office."
So the fact that there's enough here to be looked at seriously by the Serious Fraud Office shows that the Electoral Commission thinks that our law is adequate and, you know, New Zealand First Party does appear to have done something wrong under it.
It was late last year that reports with questions about the New Zealand First Foundation first came up. There were claims the foundation paid party expenses and that some of the donations weren't declared. There's no word on how long the Serious Fraud Office will take.
Don't the public have a right to know, though, if it's someone they are being asked to vote for in the election?
Look, I think everyone deserves to know the outcome of this process, but it needs to be done properly. We need to give the Serious Fraud Office the time and the space to do their job and suspend judgment until they have.
The timing important, with only 8 months till New Zealanders vote.
Yes, bad timing with the election coming up. Let's go live now to political editor Jessica Much-Mackay. Give us your analysis, Jess. What sort of political fallout could this trigger?
Well, you've got a situation where the Deputy Prime Minister's party is being looked at by the Serious Fraud Office. In election year, as you say, it's bad timing, it's messy. The last thing he wants to be doing is spending the next 8 months talking about political donations, especially as his party is going to have to work really hard to get over that 5% threshold. But it's not just New Zealand First. The Prime Minister put on a brave face this afternoon, having to defend her coalition partner for about half an hour at the media conference just before here at Parliament. The Serious Fraud Office have been busy. They have had to investigate a complaint laid by Jamie Lee Ross into the National Party this political term as well. And only 2 weeks ago, four charges were laid over that. Winston Peters does not want to be next on the list.
Thanks very much for that, Jess. Our Parliament, Jessica Much-Mackay.